1900 metres, first leg of the pick six. Start to hit the lever, runners sent on their way from the 1900, and Weasel was very slow to go, very untidy beginning this one. To give them a chance to settle down for a leader, Facebook Filly is right there shortly after the start. Just a Flasher with the noseband and green cap is right there. One of the fighters is Lady Arrow, moved from in to out. Fragile Flowers on the left-hand side, the big white noseband. Black Dynamite has the black blinkers. Facebook Filly is now near the rail. Viva Lorraine, Wimmerware is on the outside. Then Mbuta Castrum. They're followed then by Lady Arrow. Further back is Magical Dynasty and Weasel's the trailer. And they're tracing about 7-8 lengths off the leader. Fragile Flower, she takes it up into that first corner to lead a length and a half. In second, Wimmerware, just a Flash is at the rail third. And Mbuta Castrum's caught three deep along the inside. Black Dynamite, then comes Facebook Filly. Facebook Filly races about four lengths off the leader. Then Viva Lorraine, Magical Dynasty. Further back in the field is Lady Arrow. And behind that is Weasel, about 5-6 lengths first to last. As they move towards the 600-meter mark, and Fragile Flower by one length, Wimmerware is with the yellow sleeves, just a Flasher, just waiter at the rail. Then Facebook Filly, Mbuta Castrum on the outside. Black Dynamite between runners, Viva Lorraine towards the outside. Magical Dynasty goes in. As they approach the 500-meter marker, Fragile Flower the leader. Wimmerware tries to put on the pressure. The long striding, just a Flasher now being asked the question. Down the inside, Magical Dynasty. Fragile Flower, they hit the front at the 200. Down the inside, just a Flasher. Wimmerware still right there. Fragile Flower's digging in deep over the last 100. Just a Flasher's now coming on well. Magical Dynasty on the inside. Fragile Flower's looking for the line. Down the inside, Magical Dynasty. Fragile Flower just made it. Magical Dynasty second, then just a Flasher. Number one, Fragile Flower, now in the care of Duncan Howells, Brandon Lorino. And this filly by Var, she ends up breaking a maiden ticket the eighth time of asking. And she was looking for the line in the latter stages. She ends up winning at about a neck to a half length. Magical Dynasty runs a good race back in second. Third placing, just a Flasher, number two. Then number five, Wimmerware. Further back in the field is Lady Arrow, who was a fighter with Mbuta Castrum, and then Weasel, who was slow out of the gates. And then it's a good couple of lengths back to Black Dynamite. And further back in the field, well, we'll take a look at that on. Fragile Flowers, two off the left-hand side at this stage from Wimmerware. And then further back, just a Flasher. Magical Dynasty on the right-hand side starts to come on well. Fragile Flowers being hard-ridden. They race wide apart. Fragile Flowers starts to drift towards the inside and ends up winning it by about that half length. Magical Dynasty will run into that second position. That's the running of the fourth race. Race five starts off our jackpot. Back to the studio.
Fragile Flowers come through to win the running of race number four. That was the tote favorite. I've got Brandon Lorino with me, who rode it for the Duncan Howell stable. Brandon, that was a great ride. I watched you did all the hard work. You jumped from a wide stall gate and you took it up early, and it really stayed on to win a good race.
Yeah, she stayed on well. We didn't intend on leading, but I had to take the bull by the scruff of the horns and take it up. And I let her dictate the fractions. I didn't quite, you know, ease her up or chase her forward. She just sort of settled into her position nicely by herself. And she gave a nice kick towards the end, yeah, and was courageous in the last furlong.
I think the question mark for Fragile Flower was obviously the trip. I think having a look at trying the trip for the first time, but from today's effort, it stays.
Yeah, no, both Dunks and I, we're of the opinion that she'll enjoy the extra today. And, you know, it's nice to get it right.
Great stuff. Well, top ride. Just to touch on another one of yours today, One Cool Dude.
I think he's a big runner today. Provided we have a little bit of luck from the draw, I think it'll be hardest to beat.
All right, great stuff, Brandon. Well, good luck for the rest of the day.
Thank you. Well done to Amelia. Well done to Dunks and Kath. And this one's for my Uncle Gil. He's in hospital. And thanks to my sponsor, CC Craner. Thanks.
Great stuff. Let's get the trainer, Duncan Hulls. Dunks, as I said to Brandon, question mark was staying the distance. You guys thought it would. It has, and it stayed every inch.
Look, you always got a question mark being by VAR.
Sure.
But, you know, she's been a very immature filly, and she's battled to handle her racing. I've actually pushed her a bit this month, and I said to Emilio the last time she ran, it's too short now, we've got to go further. And thank God we were right. You're not always right in these sort of cases, but she won a good race today. It wasn't our intention to go to the front. I thought Brandon rode a very mature race on the horse. He, when he was in trouble, he took the horse to the front, knew he was on a fit horse, and he won well.
And he asked it the question at Fortin. I mean, all the other horses had every chance to win it, but Fortin, what a gutsy performance.
I think that even though she's taken a good few runs to win a maiden, I've always nursed her along, and I've used her racing to bring her along more than try to train her fit, and this filly will go on from here. She'll win a good few more races.
And then, Dunks, your stable's been ticking over the winners. You've got quite a fancied horse and one cool dude today. Do you give it a big chance?
I do, yes. I've always had a high regard for him. Obviously, the draw's not in our favour, and you are racing against quality horses, so you don't want a bad draw. A bad draw's a bad draw. But if he gets luck in running and everything goes his way, he's a big runner today.
Because I must say, I've watched the replay of that last 1,200-metre race about 8 times. I get goosebumps every time I watch it. He's come from like 12 lengths off them.
Well, I must be honest, 400 out, I didn't think he was going to win, but he put in a good effort. Was in soft ground, so it could be a little bit flattering. But, you know, he can't do more than what he's doing at the moment.
Great stuff, Dunks. Well, well done with this winner. Maybe see you back later.
Great, thanks. Just well done to Emilio. He supported us, and it's his second winner for us now. And then thanks to our sponsors winning form. Thank
great
you.
Stuff, Duncan. There we've seen the running of race number 4. That's gone the way of number 1, Fragile Flower, from the Duncan Howell stable, ridden to victory by Brandon Lorena. Congrats to the owners. Emilio, we heard Duncan congratulating him. And that was bred by the Harjo Stud Close Corporation. And that is a 3-year-old daughter of VAR. Very surprising to see this VAR daughter stay the 1900, but it's done it in facile fashion. Well done to Fragile Flower and to the Connections. We'll see you back for race number 8.